Hello, and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. My name is Errol, and today we are going to take a look at customers and leads. Within the Method CRM, you have customers and you have leads. You have the Customers tab, and you have the Leads tab. And you might be wondering what the difference is between customers and leads. If I were to open up a customer, and if I were to open up a lead, you would probably say to me, "Hey, Errol, I'm taking a look at the customers and the leads, and I don't really see much of a difference." And you're right! There isn't that much of a difference between a customer and a lead, except for that a lead is a potential customer. A lead has not received any of your service. So if I were to look at the customer, Dave Case, he has a current balance, where Davy Chase, a lead, doesn't have a balance because she hasn't done business with you yet. Furthermore, leads are not put into your QuickBooks file. And to prove this, in case you don't believe me, here is my QuickBooks file. I'm just going to go into my customer center, and I will search for Davy Crockett. A different one, really. Anyway, if I search for her, you can see there is no Davy Chase in my QuickBooks file because she is a lead. And that is pretty much the only difference between a lead and a customer, and your hope is that a lead will turn into a customer, because then they will pay you, and that's always a good thing. Now, if you were to scroll down to additional info, you will find this section over here, and it's a little bit different than the additional info in a customer. In a lead, you can set the status of a lead to open, qualified, or unqualified. You can set the rating of a lead to cold, hot, or warm. There is also the lead source, how you found the lead. You can create custom lead sources with the ellipsis button, and you can also set from what campaign you may have gotten the lead from. I won't go into too much detail with any of that. Every business has their own terminology that they use. What I do want to show you is this convert to customer button. There are many ways to convert a lead into a customer, one being this button. However, the important thing you should realize is that once a lead is converted to a customer, it gets pushed to QuickBooks and can never be turned back into a lead. Unless, of course, you do something like delete the customer in QuickBooks and then re-add him or her as a lead. So there is no automatic way to go from customer back to lead. Now, there are situations where Method will convert a lead into a customer automatically. And remember, you can't turn them back. One way is if you create a transaction for a lead and that transaction gets synced with QuickBooks. For example, here I'm creating an estimate for Davy Chase, who is a lead. Near the bottom, you will find a checkbox called Wait for Sync Approval. With this checked, QuickBooks will not be updated by Method, and your lead will not be automatically converted to a customer. Watch, I will save this, and I'll scroll on up here and refresh the estimates grid. Note that our estimate shows up here, but there is no estimate number, so it didn't sync with QuickBooks. If I go over to the leads and contacts list, you can see Davy is still a lead, and I'll refresh the grid just to prove that. However, if I were to go back into that estimate, and if I were to uncheck, wait for sync approval, and save this, this estimate is now synced with QuickBooks. And Davy Chase has been automatically converted to a customer. I can go to the estimates grid and I can see that the estimate now has an estimate number. And if I go over to the leads and contacts tab link and refresh, Davy is gone. She's not there. But if I go over to the customers tab and to the customers and contacts tab link, do a quick refresh, ta-da! There she is. Davy has been successfully converted to a customer. So the lesson here is that automatic conversions happen with transactions, like estimates, sales orders, invoices, etc. But it also happens when you close an opportunity. Let's say an opportunity was successful and the contact for that is a lead, then that lead will be converted automatically to a customer. Look, my opportunity was successful, and so it's now asking me to convert the lead into a customer. Of course, this only happens when the opportunity is successful. It's not going to happen when it's not. Anyway, sorry for that aside. If you want more information on opportunities, there is a video for that, just like everything else. One last thing. Some people want to import their leads into Method. And you can do this to your heart's content. But a common mistake is to import your leads in as customers. And that's not good at all. Because remember, you can't turn a customer back into a lead. But no worries, we have a video for that as well. Ha 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 ha. I got your bases covered. And we're done. We are done with customers and leads. If you have any questions, by all means, leave them in the YouTube comments, or you can tweet us at Method CRM. I hope you have a great day and take care. Bye-bye.